Hello there, Carpologists. I'm Joe, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Sonic Armatech 60 Rolly. Now, this is the second part to two videos because the first one was how to set this thing up because it's slightly different to some other items on the market, but this one is more of my general overview. I've been looking forward to getting my hands on one of these because I first saw this at the trade show at the tail end of 2018 and I love some of the features it had on it. Really nice shelter, and I've finally got my hands on it. And I know that you guys are interested as well because I've been receiving plenty of messages about people asking me about this shelter. So here we have it. I'm about to dive in, but if you want to know more about how to set this thing up, then remember to go back to the other video. And the size and frame of it is nice and sort of compact footprint if you have a look at the ground sheet. But the way it's designed is that the bed chair can be pushed all the way to the back, plenty of room around the front because it's a nice flat backed design. So plenty of space in there. And height wise, as you can see, stood next to me, probably looking about just over 5 foot for the top rib. So it's not tiny either. So if you're a bigger person, don't like to crouch down so much, nice amount of space in there to start with. And now the frame. If you've seen the other video on how to put this together, you'll have seen this in more depth. But to cut a long story short, you've got a nice rigid bar through the front here which you put into place. So that gives the front a nice amount of tension that you can push down that, and it's not going to flop in the wind, so that's not an issue. It's also nice and stable. You've also got two side compartments with bars, so that keeps it nice and rigid as well. So when it's in position, it's going to take a lot to move this around. Next up, the infill panel. Now this has lots of different variations on how you can have it. To start with, how it's put on, it's used two zips. So if I pull down here, I can open this up and have one massive letterbox opening if you want. So if, rather than just the door having a letterbox function, the whole front has that. And of course, you can take the whole thing off as well. Moving on to the door itself, you've got different variations once again. At the moment, I've got the solid infill panel in place, so that can be removed and unzipped completely. And you can then put the clear PVC cover on as well. And obviously there's a mozzie mesh one there. And if you want, you can remove the mozzie mesh so you can have the clear PVC and then this one if you'd rather. And also can completely unzip once again. So the door also has a two-way letterbox function. You can take it completely off if you want to, or zip it all the way down to the bottom. Really is up to you. And on the sides, you've got mozzie mesh vents as well, so you've got a lot of airflow going through. But also, there's these little spacer bars that comes provided with it, so you can open these out, allowing airflow, but still preventing any rain from getting into the shelter. Now moving around to the back, and the ventilation continues. If I unzip this, you can remove the solid panel. But you can also fit the spacer bars at the bottom of this, it's velcroed, so you don't have to have it completely open, but still get some airflow. But if I remove that down, you then see the mozzie mesh inner. Once again, two more zips here, so if you want, you can fully remove that and get in and out. And this also gives me access to the vapor guard on the inside, so whether you're on the inside or the outside, you can unzip all of these, giving you lots of airflow, but you don't have to remove each of the items. Quickly jumping onto the inside, the first thing you'll notice, vapor guard. Now this is clipped into place, starting at the back, working your way forward, and this can be left in place when you pack it away. So this just reduces condensation, makes it much more comfortable in here. And you've also got these pockets at the top, things like your phone, receiver, Vivi light, something like that. Easily removed, but like I said, you can keep it in place if you want when you pack it down. To my left, these organizers. Now this is also part of the frame of the shelter. It's not needed, but it just gives it a bit more rigidity, completely adjustable, and these panels clip into place. So again, just more storage for things. So if things aren't knocking about on the floor, you've got lots of space to put things. There's the same one on the other side, so lots of storage space all over. And what I'm on, heavy duty ground sheet, clips into place. Again, removable if you don't want it in here. It just makes it all round complete protection and very nice shelter to be in. And the last few points to pick up on, you've got your rain guard, sort of rain drip down here, guttering system. Rod retaining straps either side, and you've got multiple pegging points. You can adjust the height of this. And also, all of the key areas, like this one right here, or the triangular key areas where there's a lot of stress and strain, have been three-layer reinforced construction. So nothing's going to wear on the key areas as well. A nice and sturdy shelter all round. So there we go, the Sonic Armatech 60 Rolly. Packed full of features, and I'm glad I finally got my hands on this because, like I said, I first saw this at the trade show in 2018. I was looking forward to getting my hands on it. And it is a very impressive shelter, I think you'll agree. And the fact you can change it so much to suit your needs, whether you want it as all of this as it is, or whittle it down to just the shelter to make it nice and lightweight, it really is up to you. But all of this included, rather than buying drips and drabs here and there, comes in at $399. So for more information, please visit the Sonic website. Cheers for watching, and I'll see you again soon.